Throughout a global pandemic, Brexit hassles, and the end of an international tariff war, whiskey brands and distilleries large and small have continued to launch exciting new releases. I'm fortunate in that I've been able to try a few of them, doing my job as best as I can. So here's my favorite whiskeys that I've tasted in 2021. I've also included links to previous year's choices at the bottom of the article. Some of these whiskeys have been mentioned in my column here before, others haven't. Like the past list I've done, my only true selection criteria for these choices is that I first tried them in 2021, even if they were released before then, and that they were able to be bought by the bottle. However, I've focused on whiskies that were first released this year, with a couple exceptions. As before, this list comes in two parts. Part 1, accessible whiskies, are bottles that you can still get hold of either online or in specialist shops, and should be easy enough to find and buy. Part 2, rare whiskies, are hard to find, really limited or expensive drams, sometimes all free, that I've had the chance to taste. I hope you can forgive this piece of reflective indulgence. Here they are in alphabetical order, a relatively new release from Benrahmish. It first came out in October 2020. This is a bottle that is worth every penny and sets the gold standard for what lightly peated whiskey can do. Matured in a combination of first fill bourbon and ex-sherry casks, smoky and fruity flavors are perfectly balanced into a deeply satisfying whole. This is actually the third year in a row Benrahmish makes it into my annual top 10 list, an indicator of just how good, and in my opinion underrated, this distillery is. For the last few years, whiskey company Distell has been releasing annual limited edition whiskies showcasing its distilleries, Brunehaven, Dansten, and Tobermory. This 22-year-old Lead Egg, which is the peated brand of whiskies from the Tobermory, is part of 2021's releases. I find that Lead Egg is often clumsy, which can lead to both disappointing and sometimes surprisingly good results.